Hello guys, good evening. Today we are going to discuss about drugs for mania and bipolar disorders. So what is mania? Mania means it is cyclic mood changes from happiness to depression, and the patient will be usually talking continuously and he will be having eliciting thoughts. So today we will discuss how to treat mania and what are the drugs of mania. And majorly we are going to discuss today only lithium. Okay, so drugs for mania and bipolar disorder classified as lithium carbonate and anticonvulsant, we can use sodium valproate, carbamazepine, lamotrigine. Atypical antipsychotics, olanzapine, risperidone, quetiapine and aripiprazole. So let's continue. Today we are going to discuss about lithium. So lithium carbonate, what are its actions and mechanism? What is the action on CNS? So normally if we give for normal persons without mania and bipolar disorders, normal completely healthy persons, we can see no side effects and no effects are seen in normal persons. But it is neither sedative nor euphoriant, but on prolonged administration it acts as a mood stabilizer in bipolar disorders. Acute mania, if we have to take it for 1 to 2 weeks, then we will see the improvement. Continued treatment will prevent the mood changes from excitement to depression, and the cyclical changes will be inhibited if we use it for continuously for 1 to 2 weeks. Sleep time also increases in sleep deprivant maniac patients. So what is the mechanism? First, so many hypotheses came. At one time they thought that lithium is replacing the sodium, and it is true only. Then lithium has equal concentrations in both extracellularly and intracellularly. And relative to sodium potassium concentration, we know sodium ATPase pump, right? Inside, for every 2 potassium going outside, 3 sodium ions will come inside and depolarization is occurring. But here, in according to lithium, both sides, extracellularly and intracellularly, it is isotonic in concentration. Means it is equal in both inside and outside the cells. Lithium decreases the presynaptic release of lithium decreases presynaptic release of sodium and dopamine. Noradrenaline and dopamine, but no effect is seen on 5-HT release. So it is balanced in maniac condition. It is equilibrium condition is maintaining with lithium. Lithium in therapeutic concentration, therapeutic range, I mean 0.5 to 0.8 milliequivalent per liter, inhibits the hydrolysis of inositol 1-phosphate. Here we see in the diagram, IP3 is converting into the IP, and IP undergoes hydrolysis, inositol phosphate undergoes hydrolysis in presence of inositol 1-phosphatase, we will get inositol. Inositol will be recycling to form the diacylglycerol and inositol triphosphate. What will happen? This lithium is inhibiting the hydrolysis of IP3. Then there is no free inositol. Inositol is required for the hyperactivity of the neurons for energy purpose. There is no inositol, there is no regeneration of DAG and IP3. So, and extracellular source of inositol is also very less. Normal neurons can't be affected, but hyperactive neurons will get affected, and signal transduction will be decreased in hyperactive neurons due to this ineffective hydrolysis of phosphatidyl inositol. So lithium also involved in severely in other mechanisms like signaling mechanisms like for protein kinase C, glutamate, arachidonate mechanisms, etc. What are the other actions of lithium? We know we have vasopressin hormone, which is also called as antidiuretic hormone, which is releasing from the posterior pituitary, which is synthesized in the hypothalamus. So what will happen? This antidiuretic hormone is inhibited by lithium. So if ADH is not there, there is no reabsorption of water in the distal convoluted tubule. So obviously more amount of water is lost in the patients who are using lithium. So diabetes insipidus will be the most probable effect in the patients who are taking lithium. So insulin like action on glucose metabolism. Insulin like action means insulin, what will insulin will do? Insulin will convert glucose into glycogen and stores in the tissues. So excess of fat will be seen in the patients who are taking lithium. Means weight gain is more in patients who are taking lithium. So leukocytes count is also increased by lithium therapy. We'll remember it as L4L, leukocyte lithium therapy. Lithium therapy patients leukocyte count is also increased. Lithium inhibits the release of T3 and T4 hormones. But this if T3 and T4 hormones are reduced, then feedback mechanism will be activated and anterior pituitary will be stimulated, and TSH, first TRH will be released from the hypothalamus, then TRH will act on the anterior pituitary, then TSH will act on the thyroid and it will stimulate thyroid to produce T3 and T4 hormones. So there will be no hypothyroidism in most cases, because as this feedback is managing this reduced activity of T3 and T4. So euthyroidism is seen in lithium therapy patients, but in some cases this feedback may fail and hypothyroidism may occur in the lithium treated patients. Okay, so some patients may be hypothyroid. What are the pharmacokinetics of lithium? Lithium is well absorbed orally, then the highest concentration will be acquiring in 2 to 3 hours. Maximum effect of lithium is seen within 2 to 3 hours of administration. It is neither protein bound nor metabolized. If it is protein bound, then it will freely distribute to the all. It will freely distribute in the extracellular space, and metabolism will occur. It is not protein bound nor metabolized. So it distributes in the extracellular water. It distributes in the extracellular water and it enters into the cells. It will enter into the cells. Then it will penetrate into the brain. In brain, it is uniformly distributed in total body water. CSF concentration of lithium will be equal to half of the plasma concentration of the lithium. So what is VD? VD is apparent volume of distribution. At steady state is 0.8 liter per kg. Means total amount of lithium present to the top of the plasma concentration. So 80% of filtered lithium, like as sodium, it is also filtered 80%, and it is reabsorbed mostly in the PCT. When sodium, if sodium is restricted, large fraction of sodium filtered is reabsorbed. And lithium tends to rise in the serum. Serum levels of lithium will rise because sodium is restricted and large fraction of sodium is filtered. So it is not reabsorbed, mostly it is filtered, and lithium tends to rise in the serum. Urinary excretion rapidly occurs within 10 to 12 hours, up to 10 to 12 hours. After that, this slower phase lasts for several days. T half is 16 to 30 hours. Renal clearance of lithium is 1/5 of creatinine clearance. So according we know no Krog-Gold-Frols formula, according to that we will calculate creatinine clearance. We will get up to 75 to 95 ml per minute. It is normal. If less than 75 ml per minute, there is renal impairment. So if we take it as 75, then 15 will be our renal clearance of lithium. If we take as 95, 19 will be our renal clearance of lithium. Steady state of concentration will be obtained within 5 to 7 days. So in renal impairment patients, levels of lithium higher, because kidney can't eliminate the lithium easily, as we saw before only. It is 1/5 of creatinine clearance, right? So with same dose, different individuals will attain different concentrations, but clearance is remains constant over time. 0.5 to 0.8 milliequivalent per liter is optimum for maintenance therapy in bipolar disorders. If we give 0.8 to 1.2 milliequivalent per liter, it produces episodes of acute mania. If greater than 1.5 milliequivalent per liter will give, we will observe toxic effects of the lithium. So, what are the adverse effects of lithium? If greater than 1.5 milliequivalent per lithium is given, it will lead to toxicity. What are the side effects of lithium? Toxicity, nausea, vomiting, mild diarrhea may occur, minimized by starting at lower doses. We should not start lithium at directly 0.8 milliequivalent per liter like that. We should start it slowly so that we can avoid these side effects. Thirst and polyuria will occur. Due to this polyuria, more amount of, as we saw before, diabetes insipidus is caused by the lithium. So, as more amount of water is passed in the urine, more thirst will be experienced by the patient. Fine tremors will occur at therapeutic concentration. What is therapeutic concentration here? 0.5 to 0.8 milliequivalent per liter. In that concentration also, tremors will be occurring. CNS toxicity as plasma concentration increases. Coarse tremors, giddiness, ataxia, motor incoordination, cerebellum is affected. So motor incoordination, nystagmus and cerebellar ataxia are occurring. Mental confusion, slurred speech, hyperreflexia. These are common side effects of lithium. So then overdose symptoms. When we call it as overdose, if we give greater than 2 milliequivalent per liter, then we will call it as lithium overdose. Then what are the effects seen? Muscle twitchings are seen, drowsiness, delirium, coma and convulsions will occur, vomiting, severe diarrhea, albuminuria, hypotension, cardiac arrhythmias may occur in some patients. Treatment, what we should give then? It is not specific. Normally, osmotic diuretics like mannitol, glycerol and isosorbide and bicarbonate infusion, these will promote the lithium excretion. Hemodialysis is needed if lithium concentration is greater than 4 milliequivalent per liter in the plasma. So, if we use it long term, we already saw renal diabetes insipidus will occur due to the inhibition of ADH. Some patients will gain effective weight because it is showing like insulin-like action. So, hypoglycemia and weight gain is seen. Goiter in 4% cases, as we saw before. It is inhibiting T3 and T4 effect. So, more amount of TSH. If that feedback not occurring, hypothyroidism and goiter will occur. It is seen in 4% of patients who are using lithium. Managed by thyroid hormone supplements. Lithium is contraindicated in pregnancy because if in pregnancy, if any patient took the lithium, then fetal goiter may occur and congenital abnormalities, cretinism may occur, especially cardiac function may be lost. Newborn will be born as hypotonic. Therapeutic levels of lithium can cause reduction of T wave amplitudes. We know in ECG PQRST complex is there. In the T wave, amplitude will be decreased if you use lithium. Even at therapeutic levels, it is seen. Therapeutic levels also, it is seen. At higher levels, SA node and AV nodal conduction may be decreased, and arrhythmias will occur. Arrhythmias are not frequent. We can see in some patients. Then contraindicated in six sinus syndrome. Lithium can also cause dermatitis and worsen the pimples, worsen acne. So what are the interactions? To which drugs it is interacting means diuretics. Because if we use diuretics like furosemide and thiazide, furosemide is it is involved in the sodium potassium 2 chloride transport and thiazides are involved in sodium chloride transport. If we use diuretics, then sodium loss will occur. This will promote the reabsorption of sodium as well as lithium. Then plasma concentration of lithium will rise. Potassium sparing diuretics like spironolactone and epirenolone, if we use, it causes milder lithium retention. Tetracyclines, NSAIDs like aspirins, AC inhibitors like is only spironolactone. If we use those, lithium retention will occur. Lithium reduces the pressure response to noradrenaline. Noradrenaline will act as sympathomimetic and it will cause pressure response. Lithium is reducing this pressure response. Lithium tends to enhance the insulin or sulfonuria in hypoglycemia. Neuroleptics like haloperidol can be used. Haloperidol is buprenorphine, which is coming under typical antipsychotic drugs, phenothiazones. If we use along with the haloperidol lithium, it can be used, no frequent side effects, but sometimes in combination of this, tremor and rigidity will occur. Then what are the uses? As we know already, lithium can be used as lithium carbonate only, mostly because it is less hygroscopic than lithium chloride. And it is less gastric irritant due to its alkaline property than lithium chloride. So lithium citrate is used in syrup formulations. It is another use. And in acute mania, it is effective and plasma levels will be different. We should monitor the plasma levels. So many doctors are now preferably giving antipsychotic along with or without benzodiazepines. It is better actually. Then valproate also can be used. Maintenance therapy is given for 6 to 12 months to prevent reoccurrences. In bipolar disorders also we are using lithium. 0.5 to 0.8 milli equivalent per liter of lithium is used efficiently in treating the bipolar disorders. It lengthens the time interval between the cycles of mood swings. Okay. Not totally prevented in 70% cases. It is also useful in not only in bipolar depression but also useful in unipolar depression if it is recurrent. And combination of antidepressants and lithium is often used in unipolar disorders. Lithium is sporadically used in recurrent neuropsychiatric illness, cluster headaches, and adjunct to antidepressants in resistant non-bipolar major depression. Okay, it can be used along with the antidepressants in non-bipolar major depressions. Okay, thank you guys for patiently listening to me. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you.